Howdy everybody, welcome back to Guns with Garrett. We're going to be talking about everybody's favorite rifle, the AR. Thank y'all for watching today. We're going to talk about the differences between an AR-15 and an AR-10. Alright everybody, first thing we're going to talk about today is the AR-15. These are known for calibers such as most commonly the 223, or known as a 5.56, the 6.8 spec, the 6.5 Grendel, and actually the 7.62 with 39, which is what the AK-47 shoots, is another one. I've got a couple of these sitting here next to me. I can show them to you. This is your 5.56, or like I said, a 223. Here's a 300 Blackout, which is another common round. I've got an AR pistol here that shoots these. They actually run real well with suppressors, and we'll talk about this little guy here in a little while. And another one I've got, like I said a minute ago, the 7.62x39, which is what the almighty AK-47 shoots. Alright, well, a lot of these rounds have in common is they're all pretty similar in length. You got your 7.62x39, 300 Blackout, and your 5.56 here, which are all pretty close in length. They'll all fit in the same magazine. Now, the 7.62x39 is not designed for it. This is a 5.56 magazine, which is what's in there right now. Here's a 300 Blackout, which is, the casing is designed very, very closely to the 5.56, so they actually use the same magazine. Now, the 7.62x39 will fit in this magazine, but it doesn't feed properly in the actual weapon itself. But these are shorter rounds that fit in the AR-15 models, which you might have heard them referred to as multi-cal systems. That's what they call them. But what sets it apart from an AR-10, AR-10s primarily shoot 308s and 243s. This right here is a 308 Winchester, and as you can see, it's significantly longer than these other rounds. It's not gonna fit in this magazine. So let's talk about that bad boy here in a minute. So the 308 is about one of the best rounds you can get. I shoot the Winchester Power Points. It's a 150 grain bullet, and it shoots very well out of the AR-10. This is my favorite thing to hunt with. And out of this gun right here, this right here is your standard AR-10. It is a Windham Weaponry Hunter 308 model. It's got the nutmeg wood stock and wood foregrip and everything. It's a very beautiful gun. And I am very high on Windham. They make a very beautiful AR, and whether it's the 15 or the 10. This, like I said, is the 10. I've never had a problem with this gun. It shoots flawlessly, and besides that, it's beautiful, and it will kill every time. This 308 round doesn't mess around. All right, guys, real quick before we get out of here today, I told y'all we'd talk about this little AR pistol. This is the 300 Blackout, like I said, and one quick thing here, what makes this a pistol is the fact that it doesn't have a full-length barrel. Legally, in the U.S., you have to have a minimum of 16-inch barrel to put a stock on a weapon to make it a rifle. As you can see, this doesn't have a stock. This is what we call a buffer tube. Because this is a 9-inch barrel on here, we've got a buffer tube on it, so legally this is considered a handgun or a pistol, even though it shoots a rifle round. We'll go over NFA regulations and the difference between a short-barreled rifle and an AR pistol. And we'll get into more, each of these rifles and weapons here in more detail at a later time. I just wanted to give y'all kind of an overview of some of the different types of ARs. Thank y'all for watching Guns with Garrett today. If you have any questions at all about what we went over today, feel free to post a comment in the section below or shoot me an email. Subscribe, like, join my group on Facebook, DFW Carbine and Handgun. Thank y'all for watching.